unto them that call evil good, and good evil, that put darkness for light, and light for darkness.
For decades, Greville Janner was a leading Labour politician and a spokesman for Jewish people. This was his argument that war crimes trials should continue.
They should stand trial for these alleged murders in the same way as anyone else does. And the fact that they are aged is no excuse, no mitigation.
He was at the heart of the establishment, and the establishment protected him when he was implicated in a child abuse scandal by this man, Frank Beck. Beck was jailed in 1991, and Janner's fellow MPs rallied round.
Greville Janner?
There was, of course, not a shred of truth in any of the allegations of criminal conduct made against me.
Leicestershire police still had a duty to investigate the claims, and detectives did interview the then MP. It was 1991, and no action was taken by the Crown Prosecution Service. 11 years later, in 2002, the police re-examined the case, but that was it. The CPS was not informed, no action was taken. And then in 2007, there was the third investigation. No action was taken. 2 years later, in 2009, Lord Janner was diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. The Crown Prosecution Service says a trial now is impossible.
Now, police have reopened the case, also acknowledging they have credible evidence of murders committed by the Westminster paedophile ring.
These are children. These were children at the time, and they were abused because they were children, because you could get away with it.
Former policemen too, like Kelvin Ashby, are now revealing the extent of the cover-up. How their own investigations of politicians and government officials were stopped in their tracks on orders from above.
My immediate boss told me that the decision had been made higher up the chain.
Ashby was a detective inspector when he began investigating allegations that a prominent Labour MP, Greville Janner, now a Lord, was sexually abusing a 12-year-old boy taken from a local children's home. Did you want to arrest Janner?
Yes, definitely.
Were you stopped from arresting Janner?
Yes.
What was it about the boy's story that made you think it was credible?
Well, basically, he said that he'd been collected from the children's home many, many times.
By Janner?
By Janner, in his car. And that was... We backed that up.
Lord Janner has not yet been charged. But the Crown Prosecution Service has admitted it had enough evidence to prosecute Janner all along for the sexual abuse of at least 9 children. But it may be too late. The very busy Baron Janner of Braunstone now claims to be suffering from dementia.
And the fact that they are aged is no excuse.
And yet he's voted in the House of Lords on 203 occasions since he was diagnosed.
Yeah.
So if he's good enough to vote, he's good enough to stand trial?
Yeah.
Mr. Miller grew up in a children's home in Leicester. He was often bullied at school and made to feel worthless until he was singled out by his local MP, Greville Janner, who had come to visit his school.
It was 4 years and it chose a boy and a girl out of each year. He said, you know, how would you like to come and visit the House of Commons and see Big Ben, you know, because we were excited. I'd never been to London in my life, you know, so.
So you obviously thought, as any kid would, it was a great opportunity.
Oh, I thought it was a fantastic day out, yeah, but really excited, you know.
Lord Janner took the children on a tour of the House of Commons.
The rest of the group left, and I was left on my own with him in the chapel. And then... To be honest, all of a sudden, out of the blue, he just grabbed me.
And then Mr. Miller was sexually assaulted by Greville Janner. His claim is one of those that was investigated by Leicestershire Police. But despite the evidence that was collected, in April there was anger when the CPS decided Lord Janner would not be charged with historic sexual abuse because he has severe dementia.
The fact that they are aged is no excuse, no mitigation.
It's emerged that Scottish police are now investigating claims that Greville Janner abused a teenager on a trip to Scotland in the 1970s. Lord Janner hasn't been seen in public for some time.
Greville, if I may, for a moment, as we know each other, you have been really, when I said an inspiration, a mentor, you founded not only the International Council of Parliamentarians, you also founded the International Council Against Racism and Anti-Semitism. You founded the Jewish Commonwealth Council. You were a long-time president of the Board of Jewish Deputies, as you were a long-time MP and now member of the House of Lords. So it's my pleasure to present you with this plaque, and if I may read it, because it expresses that which has been put together by all your admirers and those who have worked with you over the years and who have had the pleasure of learning from you. And it says, with immense gratitude for his contribution in founding the International Council of Jewish Parliamentarians and in recognition of a lifetime of service, the International Council of Jewish Parliamentarians honors Lord Janner of Braunstone QC for his tenacity, humor, magic, and dedication to the Jewish people. Yerushalayim, 28th of June, 2011.